Okay, this video is the third video in the 5 video series in which I have explained how to install the SSD in a HP laptop and then install Windows in it and then configure the Windows in a way that the Windows is installed and booting from the SSD while we are keeping the other mechanical hard disk as a way to increase the storage. Okay, after installing the SSD, now power on the laptop and enter BIOS setup. Now under system configuration, make sure that Intel Rapid Start technology is disabled. It might be under different tab in your laptop, that depends upon the BIOS, but make sure to look for Intel Rapid Start technology. And then in the boot options, make sure the secure boot is disabled. Then let's change the boot order. Change the order of the USB so that we can boot the Windows using USB and then install Windows. And also make sure that legacy support is disabled. So boot, secure boot, and legacy support should be disabled. Then save the settings and just exit. Your computer will boot into the USB and you will eventually arrive to this screen. Then select the necessary options and then next and install Windows. Accept the terms and conditions. Now let's choose custom install. Now you can see we have these so many partitions in my hard disk. Just delete all the partitions one by one and make sure that you have already backed up all the data in a different hard disk, or maybe you have backed up all the data online in some backup storages. Then delete all the partitions. As you delete all these partitions, they will merge into a single unallocated space. Just keep on deleting everything. And this disk 0 is the hard disk, that Seagate hard disk, and disk 1 is our SSD. Just delete everything. Okay, now we have only 2 unallocated space. Choose the drive 1, that is the SSD with 250 gigabytes of space, and install Windows on it. That is, click on new and then apply. Okay, Windows will create some partitions for its functioning. It's okay, nothing to be worried of. So Windows has created 1, 2, 3, 4 partitions. It's fine, just click next and Windows will start installing. Let me put a stopwatch if you want to see how fast Windows installed on the SSD. I'm just going to fast forward this part. Thank you. So it took 7 minutes and 32 seconds finally to finish. And after the Windows has installed, your computer will reboot, and when your computer reboots, you will see an error stating that no boot device was found and that please install an operating system on your hard disk, something like that. So this is where you need to power off your computer and open the service bay again, and we need to take out the hard disk this time and just put back the cover. Put back the screw and then put back the battery. Then boot up the computer. Now this time you will notice that the computer has booted into the SSD and into the Windows that we have installed on the SSD. Let's just finish the installation of the Windows operating system. Select your region, then keyboard layout, then you can choose to start. Give a name to your PC. Create a password. Confirm your password. Okay. And Windows is finally installed. Now if you want, you can open my computer and you can see that Windows is installed on the 250 gigabytes of SSD. If you want to see more details, let's open disk management. And now you can see that the SSD is considered as the disk 0 because we have taken out the hard disk, and our C drive is on the SSD. So this completes this video. Now I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.